Soledad Flats, Nevada. The time, 6:15 a.m. Operation A-Bomb test underway. Ready to record the radioactivity from the closest possible vantage point. Bomb bay doors open. Detonation minus 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
I'll tell you the whole story. Controls jammed.
When I regained consciousness, I was on a table.
Next thing I knew, they were coming at me.
I could see something strange and eerie pulsating in front of me. Then one of them lowered it toward my chest. My own heart.
Who are you? What are you doing to me?
Can't you speak? Who are you?
You are quite well. You have recovered from your unfortunate accident.
Who are you?
A scientist, like yourself.
Where do you come from?
From a planet, yet unknown to you.
You know my name, you speak English.
We speak every language.
You can't expect me to believe that. I'm getting out of here.
Stay where you are.
Who are you?
I have already told you that.
How did you get here?
Here. In our machines, magnetically propelled across the electron bridge we have created.
Electron bridge? You mean you come and go just like that? Without anyone ever seeing you?
Our ships have been sighted on numerous occasions by your people.
Then why haven't we been able to track one down?
We have a warning system similar to your primitive radar. Our machines are set to change course at the mere approach of a pursuing object.
Where are we right now?
In a cavern, within the upper crust of the Earth.
How long have we been here?
Since the beginning of your experiments in nuclear fission.
What have you got to do with that?
We are accumulating the energy released with each of your atomic explosions. One moment.
What was that?
A report from the monitor we sent to the surface to obtain the results of your last nuclear test.
Results? They'll take days to analyze and compute.
I think you will find the figures are correct.
Can't believe it. Where is that man?
You don't recognize the area?
No.
He is in the vicinity where you crashed.
That rock was glowing.
A normal reaction in view of the amount of radiation absorbed. You have a remarkable memory, Doctor, considering the fact that you did not survive the crash.
What do you mean?
The mechanism of your heart had ceased to function. It was necessary for us to revive it. You were dead.
Well, that's what they were doing. You didn't even try to help the pilot. Why did you save me?
Because we had an important need of your services.
Such as?
Look this way, Doctor. You will understand. You are the first of your world to be looking at our solar system, the Astron. This is our planet, Astron Delta. During the 23rd time rotation, our sun began to die. Our eyes developed to this state to combat the ever-growing darkness. We were forced to migrate.
You left your planet? Where?
We invaded these neighboring planets. They were nearer to our sun.
How many of us?
All of us. Well over 1 billion. There were feeble attempts to stop us, but we were prepared for such contingencies. And now that our sun is about to completely expire, we must move again in order to survive. Yours is the only planet in this solar system capable of supporting our civilization.
This is fantastic. Over 1 billion of you trying to come here to Earth.
We have no alternative. We have been putting our plan to work for some time. At the proper moment, the invasion will be launched from our platforms, which are being readied in space. Nothing can stop us.
This is ridiculous.
You cannot find your way in or out of this cavern. Do not try to leave.
So, you have discovered our menagerie. Don't you think you will be more at ease on this side of the cage?
Horrible. What are you doing here?
We are breeding our, shall I say, armies.
Carnivorous insects and animals?
Time comes, we will unleash them. They will spread to every continent and devour every living thing on the surface of the earth.
What good will that do you? How could you expect to survive better than we?
We have provided for that. No, Doctor. Look over there.
Somebody say something. Don't you believe me? Kurt, you understand? These giant animals breeding by the millions, they'll devour everything unless we stop them.
Of course, Doug, we will.
Colonel, you've got to arrange to set off another bomb tonight. The strongest charge we have. They're beneath the ground with all their equipment. We can blow them to pieces.
Now, wait a minute.
A strong charge will overload their units.
You don't believe me, Colonel? Kurt?
Of course we do. Easy, Doug, easy. Think I'm crazy, all of you. Well, I'm not, do you understand? Everything I said is true. I saw it with my own eyes.
Give me a hand, Doug.
Now let me go! Let me go!
Steady, steady, steady. Take it easy now. Take it easy. We'll fork this whole thing over.
What are you
doing,
now?
Just drift quietly.
Oh, Mrs. Martin.
How is he, Doctor?
Oh, he's resting fine. I think he'll be all right. Control yourself, and I'll call him just as soon as you get back to your room.
You don't believe me either.
Kurt, I tell you, I've been there. I've seen what they're doing, breeding animals into carnivorous monsters. But I don't need a bomb to stop them. I figured it out. It's all here. Now look, here's the nuclear strength of our last test. And this is the amount of electricity needed to control it.
Let me see that.
I had to estimate the conversion rate of their transformers.
These figures are correct. Such transformers must operate on a constant supply of electricity. Where could they get that much electric power?
Only one way. They must tap it from the main lines of the powerhouse. 8 to 10 seconds, that's all I need. That gap in supply will short out their resistors and the whole thing will go up.
But you won't go along with that.
No, no, no. Run! Dr. Martin. I couldn't stop him, Doctor. He went that way.
He did what? How long ago? Right, we'll leave immediately.
What's wrong, Colonel?
Dr. Martin. He's on his way to the powerhouse. Wants to cut off the power supply.
Let's go.
are the main switches?
Hey, what's the matter with you? You sleepwalking or something, mister?
Where are the switches that control the whole of that blast area? And where are they?
Six.